Yo, hey Leslie, how are you? My volume's so low. Give me one sec. My microphone is too loud. Me fix this. Right, shit better. You guys can hear like, hopefully the volume is okay. Not sure why there's so much static in the background. No, that's just my PC fan. Yeah, how are you guys? Okay, so all right, see you. Have a good one. All right, let me show you guys something. So basically, yesterday I was working on rewriting the entire project. And right now I'm working on writing the unit tests. So you can see right over here that I have my coverage, which basically means which lines are covered, and it shows you the percentage. And you can see that we have a lot of red. So our goal is to make sure all of these files are being covered by our unit tests. So that's going to be the goal of the stream, is to get to 100%. So I think it'll be shouldn't be too hard, if I'm being honest with you. But yeah, it'll be lots of fun to do. So let me actually do this real quick. Let me open this. All right, so you can see over here I have a HTML file. It actually shows you the coverage. So we can see over here we have index.ts. Everything's been tested already. Same thing with the scaffolder. All of this has been tested as well. I just wrote the test cases for all of this. So we are going to actually write the test cases for template generator. So let's go ahead and do that. Me move this to the other screen. Okay. Alright, let's see. This shouldn't be too bad. Let me actually put all my files in my mock real quick. Alright, let's expect these to be truthy as well, just to make sure that they are. Perfect. Alright, so now that we know they're truthy, we can actually start testing these. So I think the first thing I'll do is probably test initialize. So let me actually do this. Yo, what's up, Radicals? How are you, man? Welcome back to the stream. I am just simply writing some test cases for this project, like I said yesterday. What's up, Ozkin? How are you? Hopefully I pronounced your name correctly. I'm doing okay. Thank you for asking. We're just writing test cases right now. The goal is to get everything to 100% today. So I'll be on for some time. Alright, good. I think, to be honest with you, once today's over, once I'm done with this testing, it should be fine. I think. I'm not sure. But I want to release it today. How are you, Daily Tech? How are you, Lester? I think I can release it today, probably, because I'm done with everything. There's just like some tiny stuff that needs to be fixed up, but I think those will be okay. But I want to get all the testing done before I release it, so that shouldn't take too long. Describe, generate, utilities. You guys get to watch me write tests all day today. How are you? Kartik and Heaven Dude, how are you? Who is Slappy? Slappy is a package, a project CLI tool. I'm gonna send you a link. There you go. Let's see, so Is Slappy like a Discord bot? No, it's a tool that you can use to generate a Discord bot project very easily. So the goal is to make it easier to just create your bot without needing to worry about setting up the infrastructure. Let me move my monitor more closer. All right, there we go. Will it support Python? At some point, yes. How long have I been scripting? A couple years. Why TypeScript? Because TypeScript is a lot better than JavaScript in so many ways. I'll never go back to JavaScript ever again. So this should just give us back our mock paths. So it'll just take in the source path and then it'll concatenate everything with slash commands, slash utils. Should be okay. Struct source path util structure source path commands. Okay, that's fine. Why is TypeScript better? Because, well, first of all, it has type acquisition, type annotation, and it has a lot of safety checks. JavaScript doesn't have any of that. And the IntelliSense with TypeScript is a lot better because you can actually create interfaces to type annotate your objects, so you can actually get IntelliSense. And it's also compiled, like it compiles down to JavaScript. And the compiler will catch errors, so it will do null checks. You can also configure it too. If you've been a JavaScript developer for a while, like if you've only ever coded in JavaScript, you may not realize the main importance of having like a static compiler, like a Java compiler. For Python, I'm probably gonna do Python later. I have no plans for Python right now. Unless someone wants to do it and create a pull request after I'm done with everything. Cancel this real quick because I need to mock all these functions one time. I definitely think it'll be a lot better for the first time. Biggest challenge of testing this is going to be it's going to be testing it like an integration test. That's gonna be something fun to figure out. I'm not sure how I'm gonna do that, but I'll figure it out. Can I actually do this instead? I think I'm just gonna mock. No, I don't think I can actually mock those functions. Yeah, I don't think I can actually mock those functions. Is it doing this? Oh, it didn't log it. How old am I? I am old enough. I'm in my 20s. Okay, good. So it's not calling the actual functions. That's good. Yeah, we don't want that. We don't want that. So the reason why I have all these spies is because originally it was calling the actual functions, but we're trying to test this specific function. So I need to mock all of these other functions. I think it might be better if I kind of put this function somewhere else because it just does so much shit. My first language I coded in was Java, and I've been coding for about 4 years now. You're good. No need to be apologetic for questions. How do I decide whether or not to use Express? For me personally, I usually look at the application that I'm building and if it's a small application, then I'll just use Express. If it's a big application, then I'll use something else like Nest. Perfect. Perfect. All right, so we just tested this whole function. Now let me run my coverage. So you're gonna see right now it's at 40.58 Let's run it again. 45.69. If I go here, refresh. Perfect. Love ASMR. Yeah, I'm eating some crackers right now. They're really good. Creating events doesn't work with Slap. You have to use arrow keys to s you have to use your space bar to select the events. You can't use enter. You use arrow keys, and then use arrow keys. You hit space, select the ones that you want, and then you hit enter. All right. Let's test get paths real quick. Yo, what's up, Fract? How are you? All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so we expect this to be called 8 times, so it should pass. I am writing test cases for Slappy. That's interesting. Do I have any examples of TypeScript Discord bots? I do not. Infor I think I actually do. Well, I mean, Slappy generates a TypeScript Discord bot, so I guess you can use that to generate one and kind of like see how it's implemented. Yo, what's up? What's up, my little kindness Roblox? Yeah, I remember you. How's it going, man? Do I sell Discord bots? Not really. I don't know. I never got into that. Why is it saying zero though? What the hell? Oh, you know why? Maybe I may have mocked something. Let me try something real quick. Hey, have you ever, hey, you know about the new AWS Mac OS since have you ever launched up one? No, I haven't heard of it. I can't find what's making certain bot, like I've been trying to find a way of doing it, but I can't search anywhere. Okay, I've had a feeling the previous mock was messing that up. Perfect, there we go. Well, what is it that you need to code? Do I work this fast in my day job? I try. I try. I am using Nord. Will AWS launch new Mac OS instances? You can use Xcode all on the platform. The problem is I'm getting errors, and I thought you tried it, and I was hoping to ask you for help. Yeah, sorry, I've never tried before, so I can't really tell you much about that. Filecons, it's material. Sure, I'll look into it. No answer to what? You didn't even ask a question. I don't, sorry. I mean, the Discord server is in the link, so you can check it out and ask your question there. Have I ever thought of making Minecraft streams again? Sure, I have thought about it. I'm not sure when though. I don't really play video games that much anymore. You would be pushing way more frequently if this was a work project, right? Well, I'm on a rewrite branch. I'm on my main branch, but ideally, yes, whenever you're working on a project, you want to commit your code in small pieces. Yo, what's up, Hopes? How are you, man? Welcome back, dude. Hope you're doing well. Is the stream laggy, by the way? How do you make it so on your Discord profile it says none of your business? You have to go into your settings and you need to search Discord and then just edit it through there. Just try to stop you to generate a TS bot. Oh yeah, there, that's just an error. Just get rid of the async and you'll be fine. I forgot to fix that. And I've been touching PHP jQuery pretty fun. That's good. Yeah, man. Definitely. Perfect. Alright, we got a lot more functions to test, but those are going to be easier because they're smaller. I will be right back real quick. All right, I'm back. Ayush, how are you? View is better, by the way. Interesting. What about view makes it better? We got a lot of functions to test. And our test passed. Awesome. What's up, Joseph? How are you? All right, I think the stream should be better now. It was laggy a bit. It was laggy a bit. All right, there. I think it should be better. It should be way better right now. Is it better now? Let me know if it's better now, because I changed something. All right, yeah. I actually forgot to turn off my VPN before I went live. But I'm glad it's better now. There we go. Where's the issue? There we go. Passing every single test. Alright, this is gonna be so annoying to test, but. I don't know, sorry. Yeah, I don't really use Mi 6, so I can't really tell you. Why is this giving me an issue? So annoying. Oh, wait, hold on. I just realized something. Hopefully this doesn't break my entire tests. That would be horrible if it does. Hope it doesn't break my tests. Okay, thank God. Okay, but that doesn't change what's going on over here, though. F2. Oh, nice. I'll keep that in mind. Thanks for letting me know. All right, there we go. It's passing. I don't really know what to tell you, to be honest. This is kind of just something that, I mean, I don't know if they have specific tutorials. You can look through the source code of Slappy, and you can look at what it does. Like, that's good. That's the start. Yeah, no problem, man. Thank you. I've been following your Discord dashboard to learn React from scratch, of course, using docs. That's good. I'm glad to hear that. Yo, what's up, Samville? How are you, man? Welcome back. I'm doing good, thank you. Thanks for asking. Would you make it to do MD at some point? Yes. Of course. I'll do that later, though. Yeah, you got it. Awesome. I am writing test cases right now for Slappy. Slap is a CLI tool to generate projects for Discord bots. Yeah, it's a good way to create a project really quickly. So you can just generate it from scratch. No need to set up the configuration. It just does it for you. So you can speed up the process. No, well, it depends if you're using. Well, okay, so Slappy is more for if people who are using command handlers, because with a command handler you have to set up the registering the command file, and a bunch of stuff. And it becomes annoying to have to, copy and paste the same thing over and over again. So with Slappy, it generates the project for you, so you don't have to worry about doing that. Especially obviously if you're writing it from scratch without a command handler, it's obviously a lot simpler. But if you're using command handler, well, how are you're gonna have to write the function over and over again. Yeah, like if you don't what's it called? If you don't use a command handler, you don't really need Slappy. If you use a command handler, then it would be nice to use it. Yo, what's up, Mortblox? How are you, man? How's it going? Have fun in class, man. Yeah, man, you should check it out sometime. I have a video on it if you want. You can go look at it yourself and let me know if you like it or not. How long will this be on? I have no idea. I can't really give you a definitive answer if I'm being honest. All right, have a good one. You guys ready? Look at template generator. Let's look at the coverage. Let's go watch it go up. It went from 50 to 87. Wow. Yeah, I knew this part wasn't gonna get tested. Yeah, we need to test this part. Perfect. Perfect. To be defined. Perfect. Right, if we run the coverage again, this part should be tested. Yep, perfect. Not sure why this part. If. Oh, I see, I see. If it does exist, it should. Throw in error if the command file exists. Perfect, it threw an error. Amazing. Perfect. Now, if I run this again, these two parts should be checked. Yep, perfect. We're almost done testing this whole thing. So let's do this. So generator by initialize define should. Slappy is a tool generator. Here's the link. You can go read about it. Oh my God. Yo, what's up? How are you? Right, this is gonna be annoying as hell. Why would you feel bad for me? You don't need to feel bad for me. When will Slappy version be uploaded? Soon. I have some videos if you want to watch it on how to make the command handle from scratch. Do you think the plugin dependency should be different from the actual CLR the same? What do you mean? Plugin dependencies different from the actual CLI? I mean, what I'm thinking is for plugins, every plugin will need to have a prompt as well as a runner. So I think that's the best way to do it. So for example, if you want to write a plugin that generates a .env, like it'll ask for .env before. Yeah, I actually thought about this earlier. I think I know how to do it. I'll look at it later. Am I really good at coding? I'm okay. I don't think I know everything. I think I know a good amount, though. Rajiv, how are you? Okay, something's wrong with this. Yeah, it's likely the try catch. Yeah. All right, there we go. You have really inspired me. Well, I'm glad. What is Slappy? Click on the link in the description and it will explain to you what it is. The TSC script is just so I can use the TSC command locally. And I'm glad you like it. You should try it out. Download it and see if you like it. Yo, Voltix, how are you, man? It's going good, what about you? Do I have a Twitch? I do have a Twitch, but I rarely stream on it. Vladlin, how are you, man? How's it going? I know what the issue is. Stupid but smart, how are you, man? Welcome back to the stream, dude. All right, see ya, man. Take it easy. Macy, how are you? How late are you? I've been on for like I think what 2 hours, I think 2 3 hours. So, I mean, I've gotten a lot. I didn't really did that much done. I mean, I did test this whole file, which is like 500 lines. But I mean, we have a lot more to test, so you didn't really miss out on that much. I'm gonna be right back. I gotta use the bathroom. Alright, I'm back. Is there any plug? Is this is any plug into Visual Studio Code for Errors? What are you talking about? Are you talking about the thing on the bottom? Oh, that's just the test stuff. It's just for testing, that's it. No, it's called Jest. It's a testing framework. It's not a package. Well, I mean, it is a package, but it's just a command. All right, have a good one. Take it easy. I don't understand, but nothing but must watch. Well, you'll understand it when you watch, so it's a win-win for you. It's a project generator. You can check the GitHub link in the description. Thank you. Well, this is gonna be fun to figure out. How do I do this? I've been asked that a lot, but I don't think I will, because there's no point. Slappy is not a framework. People don't realize that it's not a framework. You don't. If I add too much to it, it becomes a framework, and that's not the point of Slappy. So, why on earth? Why does this count? All right, I think I am going to get off. So I don't know who's still here. But I think I'm gonna get off. So if you're still here, thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you on my next stream.